One would want to believe that today was just like any other day in the life of the veteran politician. But little did anyone know that his presence at the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Foreign Affairs, Defense and Security meeting would be his last official task. He collapsed during the meeting, and moments later, the former student leader was declared dead. Tshikwamane was present during the House proceedings most of the time. In his contribution last week Wednesday, he posed a question to the Minister of Health and Social Services in the interest of the Namibian people whom he has served for years.
You might not be allowed to go into some European countries if you are vaccinated with Sinovac. Then you might not be allowed to go in a certain country if you are vaccinated with one or the other, Sputnik or whatever. So how do we as a country plan to manage this whole thing?
In his honor, fellow MPs in the National Assembly paid respect as they were to resume with the business of the day.
Honorable Tshikwamane became a member of the National Assembly for the first time in 1996 and served in various parliamentary standing committees of the National Assembly until his passing on this morning.
The speaker dedicated the day's sitting in honor of the late Tshikwamane.
It is appropriate for me to suspend today's sitting in the honor of our colleague. The House stands adjourned until tomorrow.
During his youthful years, Tshikwamane served as a student leader in the Namibian National Students Organization, NANSO. In the late 80s and early 90s, he served the SWAPO party as leader of the Youth League and a member of the SWAPO's Central Committee from 1992 to 1997. He was elected to Parliament in 1999 on the ticket of the Congress of Democrats, from which he resigned in December 2007 to form a new party, the All People's Party, in October 2009. He is survived by his wife, Louise Tshikwamane, and children.
Like me, I once was lost, but now I found, was blind, but now I see.
Timo Andreas, NBC News, Parliament.